European lawmakers visiting Manila tell Philippine senators of their concerns over alleged summary killings of drug suspects by Philippine police. The remarks of one of the visiting parliamentarian irked a senator who was once the police chief in charge of the drug war during the Duterte administration. Sherian Torres reports.
Morning, ma'am and sir.
The five-man European Parliament delegation met with members of the Philippine Senate on Wednesday. Accompanied by European Union Ambassador to the Philippines, Luc Veron, the delegation sought the meeting given their grave concern on how the Philippine government addresses its people's human rights concerns. Senators Francis Tolentino, J.V. Ejercito, Ronald De La Rosa, Robin Padilla, and two officials of the Department of Foreign Affairs received the delegation. The discussion tackled the economy, the situation of Filipino migrant workers in Europe, and various human rights issues. But what occupied them most was the Duterte administration's war on drugs.
We were discussing, as we are the Human Rights Committee, a lot of human rights issues of concern. As you are aware, the European Union has been quite worried about the war on drugs and the extrajudicial killings happening in the past.
De La Rosa, a co-accused of former President Rodrigo Duterte before the International Criminal Court on the War on Drugs case, shares how he was slighted by a lawmaker from Spain who questioned a Senate resolution opposing the ICC probe.
Bakit naman yung pati yung pa-file ng resolusyon ng isang senador, kikwestiyonin pa niya. That is too much of tinkering with our internal affairs. Who is it to question that move by Senator Jinggo Estrada?
De La Rosa says he decided to remind the delegate that the Philippines is a sovereign state and immediately left the meeting. Neumann and Tolentino, however, have different versions of the story.
It was not tense, but it was open and a critical discussion that in the end, I think, was more constructive than tense.
De, kasi yung tiga Spain, may interpreter. Kailangan talaga magtaas ng boses yon kasi hindi marunong mag-English. So yung interpreter, papasa yung mic, lalakasan yung boses. So wala naman taasan ng boses doon. I have to correct that.
The almost two-hour meeting ended with handshakes among the attendees, but neither of the parties opted to yield their own stand on the war on drugs issue.
We, as the European Union, are a member of the Rome Statute. We support the ICC, and we see this as a potential to support the investigations into the killings. We clearly understand that at least the senators we met right now see this differently.
Hinihingi natin yung kanilang respeto sa ginagawa ng ating bansa at pamunuan bilang isang sovereign state. So hindi tayo kabilang sa ICC, ginagalang nila yon at nagkaroon man ng dialogue na hindi naman mainita na ipaliwanag natin yung ating posisyon.
The delegation later held a solo meeting with opposition Senator Risa Ontiveros.
Former Senator Leila De Lima will be visited next by the European Parliament Subcommittee on Human Rights delegation on Thursday. De Lima will be marking her sixth year in prison inside the PNP Custodial Center on the 24th. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Anti-Graft Court clears the late President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. and his cronies in a graft case involving their sequestered properties. A February 21st ruling by the Sinigambayan said prosecutors failed to prove that Marcos Sr., his wife Imelda, and several of their co-accused had accumulated ill-gotten wealth through dummy corporations. The court lifted the sequestration order on the firm supposedly owned by Marcos Sr. and his associates. The government body tasked to recover the Marcos ill-gotten wealth put the value of the properties in 2009 at 2.7 million pesos. The court's decision was based on the failure of a key witness, Rolando Gapud, to testify in the proceedings. Gapud was once the financial advisor of Marcos Sr. The Sandiganbayan also ruled there was no evidence that Marcos Sr. had a direct hand in any of the corporation's stag in the complaint. The Chinese Coast Guard maintaining its presence near the Ayungin and Sabina Shoals, which are both within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. This was confirmed by the Philippine Coast Guard when one of its aircraft flew over the Sabina Shoal Tuesday. It said the plane was challenged by radio messages from a Chinese Coast Guard vessel in the area. Photos taken by the Philippine Coast Guard show 26 suspected Chinese maritime militia vessels anchored in and around the vicinity of the shoal. This development comes less than 2 weeks after a Chinese Coast Guard ship pointed a military-grade laser at a Philippine patrol vessel, sparking new maritime tensions between the two countries.
Amid rising tensions in the West Philippine Sea, Washington says it's committed to conducting joint maritime patrols with Manila. That remark made by U.S. Naval Operations Chief Michael Gilday on Wednesday during a visit to the Philippines. Gilday met with the Philippine Navy Chief Vice Admiral Toribio Adachi and Armed Forces Chief of Staff General Andres Centino. The Armed Forces says Gilday and Centino gave their assurance their country's strong defense partnership will continue, primarily through joint training and exercise. And also on Wednesday, U.S. Defense Chief Lloyd Austin held a phone call with Philippine Defense Officer in Charge Carlito Galvez Jr. Austin underscored Washington's commitment to supporting Manila and its activities in a Union Shoal. Austin also reiterated an armed attack against Philippine assets would invoke America's mutual defense treaty with the country.
Meanwhile, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says the Manila visit of Australia's defense minister is an important part of the response to China's recent acts in the West Philippine Sea. Marcos met with Richard Marles, who is also Australia's deputy prime minister, on Wednesday. The two officials discussed strengthening the alliance and defense ties between the two nations. Marles also met with Philippine Defense OIC Carlito Galvez Jr. and discussed the possibility of pursuing joint patrols in the South China Sea.
Both countries who are deeply invested in asserting the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea throughout the world, but in places like the South China Sea, where most of Australia's trade traverses. And so as countries which are committed to the global rules-based order, it is natural that we should think about ways in which we can cooperate in this respect. And so we did talk today about the possibility of exploring joint patrols, and we will continue that work, and we hope that that comes to fruition soon.
Galvez echoed Marles' pronouncement, saying both countries also seek to expand bilateral trainings beyond their armies.
The training that we have having right now is basically heavy on the army, but what we're trying to have to explore with the agreement of both governments to have an explored engagement between navies and also the air force.